Hello and welcome to 5 minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll take a look at the merge command and how it differs from the insert on conflict command. Earlier this week, the merge command was merged into the Postgres 15 branch. Merge, for those of you who are not familiar with it, is a SQL standard command that allows you to take certain data and merge it with a table and then updating or inserting or deleting values in that table. Other databases like SQL Server or Oracle have had merge for a while, but Postgres chose to not add merge a couple of years back, but instead add an alternate command called insert on conflict. Now, the community has spent more time, and you'll actually see that in this patch here that got accepted just now, there were multiple authors, and a lot of people have reviewed this as well. There's always a risk that these things don't make it into final release, but I think this is the best chance that merge has had yet to make it into Postgres. The way that merge works, you can actually see here, and we can also take a closer look at the documentation that's available already on the development branch. Essentially, you say merge into, and then you specify the table name. And again, this is the standard SQL syntax, so other databases would work similarly. And then you say using a particular data source. This data source could be a different table. It could also be a query. For example, a query here could be a values clause where you have a set of values you're trying to insert into the table, and then you're trying to decide what to do if the value already exists. For each of those input rows, you're specifying the join condition. The join condition helps you match the input data, the data source, against the target table. Then, based on whether there is an existing match on the join condition or not, you can decide to do certain things. You can say when matched, and then some other condition, for example, then perform an update, perform a delete, or do nothing. And similarly, when not matched, you can also choose to insert the data, which will often be a use case, or to do nothing. Pretty versatile syntax here, and you can see these are the standard insert update commands that you can utilize here. I would say there's a lot of use cases I can see for this. The easiest use case, of course, is if there is existing data, you can just make sure that you insert or update. The other thing you can do with this is you can also use it to, for example, update a certain balance. Here, the example in the docs is there's a customer account table, you have a recent transactions table, and then you're updating the account balance as you process that data. Then here you say when it's matched, then I'm increasing the balance. When it's not matched, then I'm inserting a new row into the customer account table with that transaction as the starting value. There's different ways of writing these queries. But in general, it's a very useful syntax, I would say, and I really hope that this makes it into the final release. Now, what I did find interesting is why didn't Postgres have that a long time ago? Postgres 9.5 added a different syntax called insert on conflict. Notice here where it says you may also wish to consider using insert on conflict as an alternative statement, which offers the ability to run an update if a concurrent insert occurs. There are differences and restrictions between those two statement types, and they're not interchangeable. And I think that's very important to know that there's trade-offs for both of these, and you may want to use insert on conflict when you don't want to use merge. You might wonder, what are such situations? Peter Gagan, who was the initial author of the insert on conflict feature, actually made a very helpful comment here on Twitter early this week when people are talking about this. The comment that he essentially made is that the downside of merge's handling of concurrency is that when you concurrently insert, so at the same time as you're executing the merge statement, there's another insert going on, then merge might not notice that. Merge would go into this insert logic, and then it would get a unique violation. I recall this back when he initially designed the insert on conflict feature, is that because of this constraint of how MVCC works in Postgres, you cannot implement merge with its general syntax and options to work in the same reliable way. If you want the generality of merge, you have to accept the fact that you might get unique constraint violations when there are concurrent inserts, versus with insert on conflict, the way it's designed with its speculative insertions guarantees that you either get an insert or an update, and that is true even if there are concurrent inserts. You might want to choose insert on conflict if you need the guarantee. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about new episodes, and talk to you next week.